There's a great article about David Corn's daughter cornering Kellyanne Conway when Kellyanne appeared last month at her high school. And David Corn, he writes for the Mother Jones magazine, his daughter asked Kellyanne about the sexual assault that Donald Trump has been accused of. And Kellyanne Conway angrily lectured this high school student, a woman, a female, telling her to get over it, to get over sexual assault. The American people don't care about sexual assault. They care about jobs, and Donald Trump will create jobs, and that's more important than sexual assault. Kellyanne Conway is a piece of sometime, someday in the not-too-distant future, Kellyanne Conway she'll write a confessional about how demoralizing it was working for Donald. And she'll ask that all of us, especially women, really, really try to understand how challenging it was to survive inside Trump Tower's boys' club. She'll tell us about, I don't know, her crippling anxiety attacks, the eating disorder, the abuse, her father's abuse that made her gravitate to somebody like Trump. Of course, Kellyanne will defend the work she did for Trump, insisting she's proud of the campaign, and that like most people, she really, really thought Trump cared about the working class. She's going to say she was a true believer, but like everybody else, she was deceived. Sniff, sniff. Anderson Cooper will not so much interview as comfort her, because this book tour that she's on will be about her pain, not the pain she inflicted on America by spewing a fire hose of lies to get Donald Trump elected president. Yeah, Anderson won't ask any tough questions, because that would be rude to ask Kellyanne about the ruination she wrought, because there's a time and a place for questions like those. And a guest trying to make millions selling her book is not the time to ask about the lives she's ruined. Kellyanne Conway will sell lots and lots of books, playing the victim and distancing herself from Donald Trump. It will be a New York Times bestseller, and that will be blazoned across her book jacket. New York Times bestseller. Even though she spent an entire campaign convincing us that the New York Times can't be trusted, we're supposed to believe that the New York Times did an accurate count of how many of her books were being sold. And of course, in her book, there will be some sort of inspirational lesson that we, especially women, can take. Probably something about knowing when to lean in and knowing when it's time to lean out. Some horseshit like that. Right now, Kellyanne Conway's staying put. No book yet. Nope, no book. Kellyanne's gonna quit. Oh yeah, she's gonna quit and she's gonna write a tell-all. But right now, Kellyanne wouldn't dare walk away just because Donald Trump did something like incite hatred for Muslims, Arabs, Mexicans, and women. No, she'll walk away after Trump does something far, far worse. When he humiliates Kellyanne Conway, when he gives the job she wants to a man, when he instead offers her a demeaning job that she believes is beneath her, that's when and only when Kellyanne Conway will feel let down and disappointed by Donald Trump. That's when she'll leave to write her book and suddenly remember that she's a woman, and that women get raped. And she'll remember that it's not right for women to provide cover to misogynists, the way Kellyanne is doing right now for Donald Trump. I voted for Hillary. I don't know what Kellyanne's father did to her. Maybe it was a couple of different men. But whatever he did or the other men did, you don't have to become your abuser, Kellyanne. You can find it in your heart to forgive your father or those men. The same way, after Kellyanne quits the Trump administration and writes her manipulative confessional, we will forgive her. That's right, we're going to forgive her. And some of us will even read her book. But our forgiveness, notwithstanding, she's a piece of shit. And she will always be a money-grubbing, bottle blonde piece of shit. And pieces of shit should be forgiven, but never forget they're dangerous. Welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman, davidfeldmanshow.com. Please friend me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, do all your Amazon shopping via the David Feldman Show website. There's an Amazon banner. We're lousy with them. Every time you click on that Amazon banner and do your Amazon shopping, we get a small percentage, and it doesn't cost you more. It really doesn't. It just takes you to the Amazon site, shop away, and then when you check out, somehow they miraculously send us a small percentage of what you've purchased. Well, on today's show, we talk to one of my favorite guests, Pat Dixon. He's the host of the New York Crime Report, and he's a very funny stand-up comic. Along with David Cyrus, he's a comedy writer, recently nominated for an Emmy and a couple of Writers Guild Awards. He's written on Saturday Night Live and Triumph the Incel Comic Dog. Very funny, opinionated comedy writer. Then we go to Chicago to talk to Professor David Farris, who wrote a piece in The Week, an opinion piece in The Week that is really irritating conservatives. The name of the piece is entitled, entitled Time for Democrats to Fight Dirty. I could not agree with him more, and that's why I asked him to come on the show to talk about why the Democratic Party needs to take a page from the GOP playbook and just get in the gutter and say no. Just fight Donald Trump and the Republicans every step of the way. And then we talk to a very funny man named John Egan. He's the publisher of the Burrard Street Journal out of Vancouver. He is a purveyor of fake news. It's a parody site. You should go there, the Burrard Street Journal. Very funny website that conservatives think is real. And he's gotten a lot of traffic to his website during this election because Republicans, and we'll talk about this, Republican websites, conservatives, keep linking to his very funny website because they read these stories and they think they're true. BuzzFeed has been covering this. They did a survey. 75%, this just came out this week, 75% of Americans, according to BuzzFeed, who learned about fake news headlines, view them as accurate. And that's both conservative and Democrats. 75% of American adults who knew about fake news headlines, 75% thought they were accurate. I'm going to read you a couple of headlines and you can play along. Are these real or are these fake? Okay, this is a headline. You tell me if it's fake or true. These are actual headlines that have been out along the internet, linked to mostly on Facebook. They're always spread on Facebook. FBI agent suspected in Hillary email leaks found dead in an apparent murder-suicide. Okay, 72% of those surveyed thought it was accurate. 72% of those surveyed thought it was accurate. Write down, is it fake or is it real? Do you think that's fake or is it real? 90% of Americans think this is true. Donald Trump on refusing presidential salary, I'm not taking it. Is that true or is that false? 90% of Americans believe that headline is true. 79% of Americans think this headline is true. Donald Trump protester speaks out. I was paid $3,500 to protest Trump's rally. Write that down. Is it true or is it false? 79% of Americans think that is true. Next headline. Donald Trump says he'd absolutely require Muslims to register. 80% of Americans surveyed think that's true. Do you think that's true or do you think it's false? 64% of Americans think the following headline is true. Pope Francis shocks the world, endorses Donald Trump for president, releases statement. Is that true or false? That is a headline that has been spread throughout the internet. 64% of Americans think that's true. Next headline, 73% of Americans think the following headline is true. Trump, I will protect our LGBTQ citizens. 73% of those surveyed say they think that is a true story. Next headline, 84% of Americans believe this to be true. Donald Trump sent his own plane to transport 200 stranded Marines, okay? 84% of Americans think that headline is true. 82% of Americans think the following headline is true. Barbara Bush, I don't know how women can vote for Trump. That's an actual headline being spread around Facebook and the internet. 82% of Americans think that's true. Is it true? 81% of Americans think the following headline is true. FBI Director Comey just put a Trump sign on his front lawn. 81% of Americans think that headline is a true story. 83% of Americans think this headline is a true story. Melania Trump's girl-on-girl photos from racy shoot revealed. 83% believe that story is true. And finally, this headline, 90% of Americans think this is true. I ran the CIA, now I'm endorsing Hillary Clinton. 90% of people who saw that headline think it is true. So those are headlines that got spread throughout the internet in the run-up to the election, and they linked to stories. Some of them were true stories, some of them were just fake news. Let's see if you correctly figured out what was real and what was fake. Okay, these are the fake headlines. 72% of Americans believe this headline. FBI agent suspected in Hillary email leaks found dead in an apparent murder-suicide. 72% of Americans thought that story was real. It was fake. Headline and story. Donald Trump protester speaks out. I was paid $3,500 to protest Trump's rally. 79% of Americans thought that was a true story. It was fake. Headline, Pope Francis shocks world, endorses Donald Trump for president, releases statement. 64% of Americans thought that was a real story. When they read it, it was fake. Donald Trump sent his own plane to transport 200 stranded Marines. 84% of Americans surveyed thought that was a real story. It was fake. Headline, FBI Director Comey just put a Trump sign on his front lawn. 81% of Americans thought that was an actual true story. It was fake. These are the true stories that were true. Headline, Donald Trump on refusing presidential salary. I'm not taking it. 90% thought that was true. It's true. Headline, Donald Trump said he'd absolutely require Muslims to register. 80%. Of Americans believe that story. It is a true story. Headline, Trump, I will protect our LGBTQ citizens. 73% of Americans believe that to be a true story. It is a true story. Barbara Bush, I don't know how women can vote for Trump. 82% of Americans believe that to be a true story. It was a true story. Headline, Melania Trump's girl-on-girl photos from racy shoot revealed. 83% of Americans thought that was a true story. It is a true story. And finally, I ran the CIA. Now I'm endorsing Hillary Clinton. 90% of Americans thought that was a real story. It was a real story. Interesting. Fake news. We have a serious problem with fake news in this country and in the world. And we talk about that with John Egan, a purveyor of fake news, unwittingly a purveyor of fake news. He's the publisher of the Burrard Street Journal. Stay with us. We have a great show.